Let me begin. You have heard, no doubt, of the rather startling testimony that we heard today from the chairman of the Nuclear Regulatory Commission here in the United States, the most senior person, Mr. Yasko, who is the most senior regulator of nuclear power in the United States, who just testified this afternoon that at Unit 4 at the plants where all this is occurring, at Unit 4, there may no longer be any water in the spent fuel pool. If that is true, this is a crisis of unbelievable enormity. Can you confirm that his testimony is correct?
Well, as far as the testimony itself, I cannot directly confirm it. What I can say is this Unit 4 of Fukushima Daiichi needs continued cooling activity, and we are trying our utmost efforts to realize the cooling of the Unit number 4.
This is startling testimony from the chairman of the Nuclear Regulatory Commission before Congress. He made these statements today here in the United States. Do you not know whether it's true or not, or you simply disagree with it? How can it be that you can't either confirm it or deny it? You are the spokesman for the prime minister. That this is absolutely critical, factual, a critical factual issue. Is it true or not, to the best of your knowledge?
Well, you know, there is an ongoing situation at the site, and of course, you know, we try to share information with the U.S. government very closely. But I cannot comment on the basis of the testimony itself.
Well, let me ask you this question. You have heard that the chairman of the U.S. Regulatory Commission made these statements today. Have you gone back to any of the officials of TEPCO, the company that runs these reactors, to say, is this true? Have you gone to them and said, confirm this is true or not? Because if it's true, then it requires a completely different sort of response than what is being done right now.
Well, of course, you know, we are very, very closely monitoring the situation, and we do take every effort to bring the situation under control. And as I mentioned, you know, the preparations are now underway for further attempts to cool the reactors.
Look, I don't mean to be too persistent and in any way push too hard on this issue, but once this testimony was given before Congress, was it not incumbent upon the Prime Minister of Japan to find out whether or not it was true? And if it is true, do something about it. So have you had that conversation with the Prime Minister?
Well, we have, as I mentioned, you know, there's a very close contact, you know, between the U.S. government authorities and the Japanese government authorities. And American nuclear experts are with us in terms of tackling the situation. So I don't think, you know, there is a fundamental kind of disconnect, you know, between the United States and Japan on this.
All right, Mr. Shikata, look, I want to thank you so much for joining us, and I hope you understand that what troubles us and concerns us is that we are getting such a wholly different set of statements about the facts over there from our government officials, as opposed to what we're hearing from your government officials. And what we're worried about, frankly, is a lack of transparency there. And so I hope you understand the types of questions I'm asking.
Well, you know, this is something which is very, very important for us and for the people living in this country. And we try to provide as much information as possible. And also we are, you know, collaborating with the U.S. government experts and international organizations like IAEA.
Look, I'm sure there is all that cooperation, but I've just got to ask, the Japanese population over the course of today must have heard of the testimony that was provided before the United States Congress. It is very ominous testimony, and information like that about what is going on in the area surrounding the reactors necessarily would travel very quickly. Has the public there called you and said, tell us the truth about this?
No, I have not received that kind of inquiries. This is something that, you know, of course, we tried, as I mentioned, you know, we are trying to provide information to the public, and the Japanese public is extremely interested in the ongoing situation.